everybody, we can all get some. Come on, everybody, we'll get some now. Come on, everybody, we can all get some. Come on, everybody, we'll get some now. Hi there. That was Kingston by Greg McPherson Band off of his album Night Flares. He's out of Manitoba. Alright, I'm gonna start with a song I wrote for Melody a while back. Good enough. Here's the thing. It's been ages. I can hardly remember it. It's been that long. And it comes, but don't come easy. It's not exactly pulling teeth, more like putting them back in. Because I'm malnutrition. I've been starving for so long. We could nourish each other, get back to health. We could taste love together. Love so damned elusive, it doesn't just waltz in. Have to invite and be invited and have the courage to attend. Here's the thing. I could easily love you, and I want to, and ain't that the way best things begin? When you're malnutrition and been starving for so long, we can nourish each other, get back to hell, 'cause we're malnutrition. Been starving for so long, we can nourish each other and get back to health.
we can taste love together. Yes, we can. That's called Here's the Thing. It's an original.
Welcome, guys.
How did we meet? We met through a comment I made about a concert that was going on last summer when things kind of opened up a little bit in Ontario. And there were concerts happening indoors with social distancing and stuff, but I made a comment saying that I wasn't comfortable enough to go see a live show yet. And Melody responded to that, saying she felt the same, and she made a fairly insightful comment, as she usually does. And I just checked her out and was like, who's this? And I realized that she and I like to frequent a lot of the same places, so that began a conversation that went on and on and on and leaded to us getting together. So I would say serendipity. That's how we got together. Yes. I am looking more and more like Thor every day. The one where, you know, like later in the Marvel movies when he was like getting really hairy and fat. That's the Thor I'm after. That guy was sexy. I got new strings, so I've got to keep them in tune here. Come on, who doesn't love late Marvel Thor more than early Marvel Thor? Early Marvel Thor was just stereotype, super muscular, chiseled Chris Hemsworth. It was a lot more fun when he was, you know, playing video games with his buddies and kind of washed up. Aquaman, well, he's just like Thor 2.0, right? Same idea. Here's this giant man with inhuman muscles. And what's his name? The guy who was in The Witcher. Him too. It's absurd. I don't know how those guys do it. They must just train many, many hours a day. Your love is lifting me higher than I've ever been lifted before. So give it up and quench my desire, and I'll be at your side forevermore. That's why your love keeps on lifting, yeah, lifting me higher and higher. I said your love keeps on. Yeah, lifting me higher. Now once I was downhearted, yeah, disappointment was my closest friend. But then you came and soon he departed, and you know he never showed his face again. That's why your love keeps on lifting, keeps on lifting, keeps on lifting me. Yeah, lifting me higher and higher. I said your love keeps on, yeah, lifting me higher and higher. Well, I'm so glad that I finally found you. Yeah, my one in a million girl. And now with my loving arms around you, I can stand up and face the world. That's why your lip keeps on lifting me, lifting me higher and higher. I said your love keeps on, yeah, lifting me higher and higher. That's Your Love Keeps Lifting Me Higher and Higher, sung by Jackie Wilson, written by Gary Jackson, Reynard Miner, and Carl Smith. Yeah, the dancing goo Heather. I think that was Ghostbusters 2. The dancing goop. Thank you, Kelly. Oh, Dina, I have a song for you. I gotta remember what it's called again. Somebody told me you wanted to hear this song, so I'm gonna sing it just for you. Yeah, just for you, Dina. It's not even on the request line, but that's cool. I don't think I'll ever, you know. Well, hopefully you like it. I mean, I don't know if I can do justice to it, but I heard you wanted to hear it, so here we go. We're no strangers to love. You know the rules and so do I. Full commitment's what I'm thinking of. You wouldn't get this from any other guy. I just wanna tell you how I'm feeling. I gotta make you understand. I'm never gonna give you up, I'm never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and desert you, I'm never gonna make you cry, I'm never gonna say goodbye, I'm never gonna tell a lie and hurt you. We've known each other for so long. Your heart's been aching, but you're too shy to say it. Inside we both know what's been going on. We know the game and we're gonna play. And if you ask me how I'm feeling, don't tell me you're too blind to see. I'm never gonna give you up, I'm never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and desert you, I'm never gonna make you cry, I'm never gonna say goodbye, I'm never gonna tell a lie and desert you, I'm never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and desert you, I'm never gonna make you cry, I'm never gonna say goodbye, never gonna tell a lie and hurt you. each other for so long. Your heart's been aching, but you're too shy to say it. Inside we both know what's been going on. We know the game, we're gonna play it. And if you ask me how I'm feeling, oh, don't tell me you're too blind to see. I'm never gonna give you up, I'm never gonna let you down. Never gonna run around and desert you. I'm never gonna make you cry. I'm never gonna say goodbye. Never gonna tell a lie and hurt you. I'm never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you down. Never gonna run around and desert you. I'm never gonna make you cry. I'm never gonna tell a lie. Never gonna give you up or hurt you. I'm never gonna make you cry. So there you go. Somebody told me you didn't know what a Rickroll was. Dina, you just got Rickrolled. It was so Rickrolling, Dina, is when you surprise someone with Rick Astley's Never Gonna Give You Up in any way at all, where they don't see it coming, and then, you know, you trick them into clicking a link that goes straight to Rick Astley or anything like that. So that's pretty fun. Oh, we've got some requests that have come in. That's cool. Four of them. My, my. Oh my goodness, and it's the first one on the list is one I have not played in oh so long. So this one could be painful. We'll see how it goes. I literally put like all my songs on there knowing that some of them were going to challenge me, but the good thing about it is that it'll make me play some songs that I haven't played in a while and get my chops back playing those tunes. That's the hope anyway. I wrote it because after my mother had described to me what it was like to watch her dad die. Now her dad, my grandpa, wasn't a very good person, but when he died, his eyes had been, you know, full of gunk and whatever for years, and when he died, I guess his eyes went from kind of grayed out to being the crystal clear blue that she remembered when she was a little kid, and it made her bawl her eyes out. And I ended up writing this song to kind of honor that moment. Because I thought it was beautiful, and they had such a conflicted past. Yeah. So here we go. Thank you. cannot decide to feel angry or guilty. You always said that you had it coming. Not many men get a second chance, you said, but when you did, you lived it. Oh, morning came like a bill collector, and you sighed with relief, cause it was finally over. It was raining outside, and you opened your eyes, and I cried, cause they were blue as the sky, blue as the sky. Time's passed by, I can realize that your gift to me was to watch you die. I can realize that your gift to me was to watch you die. To watch you. So that was Blue as the Sky, an original. Thank you, LV, for requesting that. I think all I have to do is check it off. It's my first time using the song request line. There we go. Yeah, I just check it off. Okay, cool. There we go. Thanks, LV. Thank you for being here. Kelly, Dina, I was very glad you were here to get Rickrolled. I was hoping you would show up, and as soon as you did, I'm like, now I'm on it. Oh, Patter wants some you too. Oh, it was Matt. Cool. Thank you, Matt. Hey, Ruth.
I was lost in Manitoba on a bender that I couldn't see the end of. I had woke up on a bus after 13 shots of ride, and I threw up on the window and got kicked off. And the snow was falling on my face. Headlights flashing by my head, I heard an engine, and I heard footsteps, and your voice saying, Jesus, buddy, you're having a rough night. Let's get you somewhere warm. Your arms around me, could barely hold my weight, and the rest is just beautiful darkness. Well, I woke woke up to the smell of bacon cooking in the distance, and it nearly made me sick, but I managed. I was covered in a blanket that looked like Grandma macramated in the 1970s, when style was just beige and brown and orange. And I spied a bucket by the bed, and I sighed with relief that it was empty, and I groaned and I heard a laugh then, and your voice saying, Jesus, but you had yourself a rough night. Lucky for you, I'm just the kind of gal who will help a sad sight. And I felt your hands in my hair could heal the sick and blind, and the rest is just beautiful madness. I'm still lost in Manitoba, doing labor with my hands that I've no skill for. And I haven't touched a drink in almost 1 year since I got here. And I don't take that for granted, because I can't. Sun, it shines down on my head. I could just as easily be dead, but I'm not, and I have you to thank for that. And you're somewhere warm where you can get it back. And when I feel your arms around me holding me tight, the rest is just beautiful dreaming. And when I feel your arms around me holding me tight, just beautiful dream. That was Lost in Manitoba by yours truly. I gotta say thank you, Matt and LV and Guy, for requesting originals. I was a little bit worried it was going to be a sea of covers I'd have to play, so it's nice that there's a mix in there. I do love the covers. I am, Guy, I'm not sure I can play Bonne Nuit Ma Chérie at this hour. I may have to move yours just down the queue, because to be perfectly honest, it's a blatantly dirty song, and I don't know, I know Matt has kids, and I wouldn't want anybody sort of accidentally overhearing some things that are a fair bit adult in nature. So I'll play it. I just think it might be best to play it more towards the end of the set. So hopefully you'll stick around for that. This next request is kind of cool. I just put this song up today. I just learned it today. Okay, if he's busy. Okay, well. Okay, I'll move it. I'll move it back up to just after this one, because now I'm in the mood and I've got my cue up. If you will, a picture of you and I engaged in a kiss. The sweat of your body covers me. Can you, my darling, can you picture this dream? If you can, a courtyard, an ocean of violets in bloom, animals strike curious poses. They feel the heat, the heat between me and you. How can you leave me just standing alone in a world that's so cold? Maybe I'm just too demanding. Maybe I'm just like my father, too bold. And maybe you're just like my mother. She's never satisfied, never satisfied. Why do we scream at each other? Well, this is the sound it makes when doves cry. Well, touch if you will my stomach. How it trembles inside. You got the butterflies all tied up. Don't make me chase you. Even doves have pride. Oh, how can you leave me just standing alone in a world that's so cold, so cold? Maybe I'm just too demanding. Maybe I'm just like my father, too. Maybe you're just like my mother. She never satisfied. We scream at each other. This is the sound it makes when doves cry. How can you leave me just standing alone in a world that's so cold? A world that's so cold and just too demanding. Maybe I'm just like my father, too bold. And maybe just like my mother, she never satisfied. Oh, why do we scream at each other? Oh, this is the sound it makes when doves cry. That's my own take on When Doves Cry by Prince and the Revolution. All right, we got some more originals being requested. Metal ballad version. I'll take it. I'll take it. All right, so this next song, if you've got kids, it's earmuffs time. Earmuffs, earmuffs, earmuffs. Although in a way, you know, like, if you're like me, you're less concerned about kids hearing and learning about sex than you are about kids seeing really gory violence or learning about bigotry. And, you know, like, I'd rather my kid stumble upon some sexy stuff than on some violent or bigoted stuff. That would concern me a lot more. So here we go. Sexy stuff. Okay, I have a story about this. Before I go, before I do this, I have a story about it. So I played a show at the Park Theater in Winnipeg, Manitoba, in 2007. It was a good show. I was playing with Jacob and Lily and Steve Schellenberg, and it was fun, but it was on Canada Day weekend, so it wasn't the most crowded show. And I decided, because it wasn't the most crowded, I might be able to get away with playing this song in this pretty fancy venue. And little did I know, there was a group of, I think, religiously conservative kids in the audience. Not kids, but, like, you know, early 20s, but, like, straight-laced. And they did not appreciate this song. And one of them threw her boot at me, and it actually hit me in the shin as it came up on stage, and it was like the most shocking thing. I was like, somebody actually threw a boot at me. And now I just kind of wear it like a badge. Like, I played a song that was so offensive to somebody that they felt the need to throw a hard object of clothing at me. And I don't even find the song that offensive. It's just filthy. It's just a filthy, filthy song. And the intentions in the song are just wonderful. So, so now that I've built it up, this shin-injuring song, I really hope you enjoy it. And I hope you're not offended by it. My chérie, good night, my love. There's hours to come with the stars above. Please don't go to sleep. It's been almost a week and we've got to get it on. Bonne nuit, ma chérie. Oh, come kiss me. Your lips are so soft and they taste like honey. We cannot go wrong if you slip me some tongue. Oh, we've got to get it done. Bonne nuit, ma chérie. May I take off your shirt? This kissing, it teases. It's only a flirt. Won't you show me your nipples? I'll nurse them like tipples. Oh, we've got to get it done. Bonne nuit, ma chérie, those bottoms must go. Those panties must slide off all sexy and slow. Then lickety-split, I shall polish your clit, cause we've got to get it on. Bonne nuit, ma chérie, I am ready. My member is calling out, come to me. So won't you jump on my knob like some pork to kebab, cause we've got to get it on. Bonne nuit, ma chérie, what is the delay? I'm starting to fall, my prick's going away. This isn't a joke, I'm getting blue balls. Please, can't we get it on? There you are. The Boot Song. I should just call it The Boot Song. Thank you, LV. I'm glad I didn't see any numbers go down as far as viewers. Oh, we just lost one now. But it may have just been somebody who had to go for whatever reason. So I bet you weren't expecting that when you requested it, Guy, but there you go. You happened to pick out one of my more utterly filthy tunes. I don't have a whole lot of them. I've got a few here and there just lurking around. That's a song that I call a 3 a.m. at the campfire kind of song, you know, like you tend to save it for that special time of day when nobody cares that you're playing it. And yet at 3 a.m. I've still had people complain about that song. Somebody actually once said, there are kids sleeping in tents. I'm like, well, so they're sleeping, so they're not hearing it. I don't understand. It's not a loud song. It's a soft, gentle song. C'est la vie. This one's for Patter. My name is Joe Roberts, work for the state. I'm a sergeant at a Perrinville, barracks number 8. I always done an honest job, as honest as I could. Got a brother named Frankie, and Frankie ain't no good. Ever since we was young kids, it's been the same come down. I gotta call him shortly, Frankie's in trouble downtown. Well, if it were any mother man, I'd have put him straight away. But when it's your brother, sometimes you look the other way. Me and Lane, we've been drinking. Nothing feels better than blood on blood. Taking turns dancing with Maria as the band played Night of the Johnstown Flood. I catch him when he's straight, like any brother would. Man turns his back on his family, he just ain't no good. Frankie went in the army back in 1965. I got a farm to ferment, settled down, took Maria for my wife. But them wheat prices kept on dropping till it was like we was getting robbed. Frankie came home in 68, me, I took this job. Yeah, we were laughing and drinking. Nothing feels better than blood on blood. Taking turns dancing with Maria as the band played Night of the Johnstown Flood. I catch him when he's straight, teach him how to walk that line. Man turns his back on his family, he ain't no friend of mine. Night was like any other. I got a call about 8:45. There was trouble out in a roadhouse out on the Michigan line. There was a kid lying on the floor looking bad, bleeding hard from his head. There was a girl crying at a table, and it was Frank, she said. Well, I went out and jumped in my car, and then I hit the lights. I must have done 110 through Michigan County that night. It was out at the crossroads, down round Willow Bank. I seen a Buick with Ohio plates, behind the wheel was Frank. Well, I chased him down those county roads, till a sign said Canadian border 5 miles from here. I pulled over to the side of the highway and watched his taillights disappear. Laughing and drinking, nothing feels better than blood on blood. Taking turns dancing with Maria as the band played out of the Johnstown flood. I catch him when he's straight, like any brother would. Man turns his back on his family, he just ain't no good.
There you go, Patter. I hope you were still around for that one. There you go, you're still there. Good. Facebook went kind of quiet for a moment there. Maybe it was just the really deep thoughts song. And from highway to patrolman to high ground is an easy switch for me. Oh boy. So I recorded this one in 2011, but I don't play it that often. So once again, I've been caught trying to play a song that I don't practice enough. So thank you for that. This one's called High Ground.
Alone.
couldn't do the big guitar solo in the middle, but there you go. That song is on my Bandcamp, just as a single. So it's like a buck if you want to buy it. It was produced in Peterborough, Ontario by Ben Davenport. And he did a hell of a job. I mean, he made it sound like it belonged on the radio. I was really impressed with the work he did on it. So if you want to hear a much better version of that song, go check it out at Bandcamp. LV requesting the Dark Ones tonight. My goodness. All right, so the blossoms were blooming for Lord Vitae. So this one is a weird post-apocalyptic song. So hopefully you don't mind those. We followed the caribou to the hills north of Malibu in the summer of 33. The cold snap was terrible, froze the ass off the mammals and the reptiles died in their sleep. And the wind that howled down from the peaks neath the Arctic froze eyelids to horrified eyes, staring with hopelessness at an iced over precipice where tears say the gravity lies. And it was bye-bye global warming, we never saw it coming. We knew that the climate was changing, but we couldn't predict that an ice storm like this would hit when the blossoms were blooming. When finally we came to old San Francisco, we'd lost 140 head, and for 38 people we cried at the side of the ice on the Golden Gate Bridge. It was 400 miles more to Malibu, nothing to eat but the caribou, and we couldn't betray the guidance they gave, 'cause they'd become family. We couldn't bear to slay when it was bye-bye global warming. To the end, we refused to stop moving, and the dying told us to keep going, so we left them behind to frigidly die when the blossom should have been blooming. Of our herd was slaughtered for meat and hides for the children and old and dying, and their blood was made into drink, and we knew that nothing would be the same, so we stared at the snow
and the frost and the fog of a breathing, and we sighed. The blossoms were just blooming.
So that was Blossoms Were Blooming, an original for Lord Vitae. Thanks for requesting that. I don't play it very often, so that was a bit of a treat. I'll play this one. I haven't played this one in a fair bit. Oh, I should have just taken a break. My drink is out. I'm going to play this. I'll take a break. Then I'll come back, play Bad Mayo. That's my plan. Oh, and I'll tune first, because apparently we're out of tune again. Brand new strings, you know. These things happen. I pull the crap out of them, but they still go out of tune. So this one's called Break. It's a bit of a weird jazz soul blues thing. Sliding doors and hidden clothes, sneaking out at break of day. Whoever thought that getting caught could stop a man, who can say? And all the lies and underwires couldn't support a heavy weight. The truth that hurts the both of us ain't no winners in this game. And in the end, it's either complicit in guilt or shame. And that's how we take me back again. But damn it, man, who hasn't heard the hollow chords of that refrain? Oh, the answer's no, you gotta go. You fooled me twice, but not again. 'Cause in the end, it's either complicit in guilt or shame, and that's how we break our heart. That's how we fall apart.
don't even stop.
Was Break, an original one that I hope to someday play with a band with a lead guitar player that's much better than I am. All right, I'm gonna do a little beverage top up. You can listen to my cat meow and you can listen to another tune. Yes, I know you're hungry, you're always hungry. Oh, we'll I'll play a little John Carroll. He's a local Ottawa guy. Great songwriter. So enjoy him while I am off doing my beverage things. And I'll be back to play Randy Newman and Black Sabbath. This is going to get interesting. Enjoy the tunes.
Everybody smokes in hell.
Well, that was abrupt. I was trying to do that smooth, but I blew it. That was a little piece of Everybody Smokes in Hell off of the album of the same name by John Carroll. You can find his music on Bandcamp. Check him out. So we've got a request for Bad Mayo. which is one of mine. So see how this one goes. It's always a challenge to play this one. It's a fast and furious one. Okay. Bad Mayo! Bad Mayo! What were you doing in my sandwich show? Bad Mayo! Bad Mayo! What were you doing in my sandwich show? I woke up one morning, I had no prescience of disaster befalling me. I was in routine, brush my teeth, get dressed and grab my coffee. Before I go to work, catch the bus. Everyone's naked and beautiful, and they want me. I got off the bus through the door. It was time to be productive. I worked hard, made phone calls, kissed the asses of my employer. Like a sandwich, so I ordered a sandwich, to be specific, a BLT. BLT. The peculiar taste. I took the waitress over and told her there's something wrong with my sandwich.
Mayo, it's the mayo,
she said.
I told the cook to throw that shit out.
I felt sick, very sick. I had to puke, so I ran for it. Bad Mayo, Bad Mayo, what are you doing in my sandwich show? Bad Mayo, Bad Mayo, what are you doing in my sandwich? My sandwich, my sandwich, my sandwich, my sandwich, my sandwich, my sandwich. That's Bad Mayo by yours truly. Someone who called themselves me requested a song. How did I request my own song? This is like a lullaby song. although there's been a few of those already tonight. This is by Randy Newman. It comes from the movie Three Amigos. Shining from the desert sky above, you know pretty soon that big yellow moon will light the way back to the one you love. Oh, shadows on the train. Little cowboy, close your eyes and dream. All of the doggies are in the corral. All of your work is done. Just close your eyes and dream, little pal, oh, dream. Soft winds blowing through the trees above. All the other little cowboys back in the bunkhouse now. So close your eyes. Blue Shadows by Randy Newman. Thanks for coming by, Ruthie. Yep. Feed your lads and get thyself ready. Even bad mayo is good, says Patter. I'm not so sure about that. Have you ever eaten bad mayo by accident? It's disgusting. That's what it is. Terrible stuff. Weird attitude. Oh my goodness. How do you guys pick the ones that, like, I don't know, you have an uncanny ability to pick ones that I haven't played in ages and haven't practiced. So, oh my goodness, this is going to be, pre-warning, this is going to be an unholy mess. It's different from holy messes. Thank you for requesting that one, that last one, Melina. It's a good one. Let me see. This is tricky business. Is it that? Is it that? That. That's what it is. It's a weird
even try. It's a weird. Young, I smoked a lot of grass, got weird as I could and opened up my head, acted out and made people laugh, spoke in tongues and many voices, played an axe with a million effects. These were all effortless choices. I never thought about it, I just did. How do I get back to that? Yeah. How do I get back? How do I get back? Quit my job, go back to chaos. Now that's just Peter Pan. Like a soulless government position, I guess there have been worse plans. How do I fulfill a weird ambition? How do I get the magic back? Is it really as simple as making the decision? Then I guess I'll do that. It's a weird.
That's a little more punk rocky than is the standard for me. But it's that song, oddly enough, transitions really well into the next song. You like that one, Melina? Oh, that's nice. Awesome. I'm like insecure about that song. I feel like I need to plug in and get my electric guitar going and make it real loud and crazy, and you know, on acoustic guitar it just, it's not quite the same. So naturally, since I really hammered down on that song, everything went out of tune. Brand new strings that go in a tune. What are you gonna do? You're gonna tune in between songs. Oh no, somebody requested La Bamba. I'm screwed. Last time I tried to play La Bamba, I messed it up so bad. Headstones. I admit I don't know who the Headstones are. Maybe you can send me a link. Send me a link on Facebook to like, if they have anything on YouTube, I'll check them out. I'm not against learning new tunes. They have to be kind of like, I don't know, I have to be inspired to learn them. Every artist that has been suggested to me, I've gone and I've checked out a bunch of tunes by that artist, and some of them I've learned and some of them I'm just like, I can't really do justice, or like their songs don't really speak to me. So you never know. I like weird songs. You may notice by the things I cover, they're not like the standard hits for the most part. This one definitely is a standard hit for this band, which is a really weird band. We'll see how this goes. Mm-hmm.
is my mind? Where is my mind? Where is my mind? Way out in the water, see it swimming. Oh, I was swimming out in the Caribbean. Where is my mind? Where is my mind? Away out in the water, see it
go. That's Where Is My Mind by Pixies.
I put my motorcycle back in the shed last week. Turning over the engine wasn't happening for me. I could feel winter's freeze and the autumn breeze. I guess everything happens for a reason. Well, Jenny said, when you gonna sell that thing? I shut the door and said, when I'm damn well ready. She's taking me across this whole damn country, and well, it's hard to give up memories. I know you loved her more than me, Jenny said, with a smile. But there comes a time in all our lives, don't you finish that sentence, I cut her off. And next week, my old bike was in the Auto Trader. Well, I raised my girl to be a good woman. I taught her what I know, the rest came from heaven. She graduated at the top of her class, got a scholarship to Massachusetts IT. Jenny cried, her baby's really leaving us. I can't believe it's happening all too fast. I said we'll be alright, it's for the best. I don't think I'd ever really lied like that. I know you love her more than me, I said, with a smile. But there comes a time in all our lives, don't you finish that sentence, she cut me off. And the next week, drove my little girl out to Massachusetts. Contract and business hit the skids. That was back in 20 when the COVID hit. We got a second mortgage. Cassie came home, told ourselves that everything happens for a reason. And when Cassie got sick, I figured she'd beat it. She was young and strong with no previous conditions, but her symptoms got worse. She was barely breathing. Called 911, watched her leave on a stretcher. I know I loved her more than myself, I said, with a smile. And sometimes life don't make any sense. Next thing that I knew, the memorial was over. Nobody to put in the ground, no ashes to bring home. Just Jenny and me. Going on somehow. Just Jenny and me. Going on somehow. Just Jenny and me.
That's called Jenny and Me Going On. An original tune.
Another man. long black veil. She visits my grave when the night winds wail. Nobody knows, nobody sees, nobody knows but me. An eternity near, she stood in the crowd and shed not a tear. But sometimes at night, when the cold wind moans in a long black veil, she cries over. Walks these hills in a long black veil. She visits my grave when the night winds wail. Nobody knows, nobody sees.
That was Long Black Veil by Mary John Wilkin and Danny Dill.
Well, now that I'm out, can't say I'm glad about it. Say that freedom is a blessing, 'cause I'm coming back home to you. Well, before I went to jail, my life was living hell. Waking up to the crack of your whip, saying, John, take out the trash, walk the dog and feed the cats, and don't forget to make lunch for the kids. But when I was in the big house, I didn't have to wake up till an hour after I'd gotten up back home. And I'd shuffle with my buddies towards potatoes and scrambled eggs, no more toast in the dark alone.
I'll leave it for the chorus.
Yes, it's sad, but it's true. Prison treated me better than you. And lately I've been pondering the question, is it worth it to get busted again?
That was just a little bit of Prison Treated Me Better Than You by yours truly. And now back to your regularly scheduled programming. We've got a little Bill Withers on request here. Now normally I would do this song on my Nashville-tuned guitar, But I broke a string last time, and I have admittedly been too lazy to string it up. I strung up this guitar, and that was my major accomplishment for the week. So, there you go. So here we go, little Bill Withers. Sunshine when she's gone, ain't no warmth when she's away, ain't no sunshine when she's gone, she's always gone too long, anytime she goes away, wonder this time where she's gone. If she's gone to stay, ain't no sunshine when she's gone, and this house just ain't no home anytime she goes away. And I know, 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 I know. I know I'll leave the young thing alone, but ain't no sunshine when she gone. There ain't no sunshine when she's gone. Only darkness every day. There ain't no sunshine when she gone. In this house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away. Anytime she goes away. Anytime she goes away. She gone, and she gone.
Michigan. Ain't no sunshine, ain't no sunshine, no, ain't no sunshine. Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Yeah. Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Ain't no sunshine. Where's she gone?
It's a little Ain't No Sunshine by Bill Withers. Uh-oh, we got a poem. All right. I gotta set this up now. Here we go. Maybe you've worked all your life at a record store called Five Alive Records, named not after the beverage, no, but after the Temptations. And maybe you've closed the gate at night, the windows barred, shut against thieves, intruders, and riots, because in this part of Baltimore, that can happen. And maybe your house is not a train ride to the suburbs, but a walk of blocks, because your ass never had the cash to own it. And maybe your life is just one big stretch after another, because let's face it, when the cards are stacked against, every gain is a stretch, and every victory is questioned and suspected. Allies? Hell yes, you need allies, but not as much as you need men to realize they've been raised and conditioned to believe that greed is good, color is a problem, and your lack of achievement is a direct result of you lacking effort. How to stop that? Oh, I'll be your ally in a second, yes, but how to stop that? Because everywhere I turn, I've got friends who want different, who want change, who speak out, whose hearts are all so much in the right place, but outrage only seems to last the seconds on the internet that gets instantly erased. And the Standing Rocks and the George Floyds and the Occupy movements born from a rage against the horror show machine, the systematic bigotry against poor and different, is too easily left behind for the next outrage, the next distraction. And the people who have the money, the big money, and the people who have the power, the big power, might love this. Or more likely, they are ignorant because they've never stayed in less than a 4-star hotel. They don't know what it's like inside the inside of a trailer. And if they've done an honest day's work in their lives, it sure as shit wasn't a hard labor scramble for their living. Or if it was, they forgot it long ago. So maybe this is all just wheels spinning, an impotent fury at the truth of our species that we can't see long term, that we look out for ourselves and those closest to us, and if it came down to myself or my closest friends versus them over there or the planet, I know who I'd pick. And it makes me sick, because I can talk all the shit I like, but in the end I have to admit, I lead a small life, and there's only so much I can do with it. And there's the rub. We're a hive. A broken line of individuals doing for ourselves but moving like a unit, none of us sure who is really steering the ship, which makes it oh so easy for conspiracy theorists and cult leaders and fascists to convince us that somebody is, and they're dangerous. When really, we're all alone, banding together here or there for mutual support, because being together feels better than any other sensation we've had the privilege to know. So there's that. It's called Five Alive. It's my, I don't know, rant poem, I guess. Covers a lot of territory. Thank you, Lord Vite. sometimes I write songs like that too, where I'm like, I'm not really trying to, it's not focused. I'm not trying to say one thing with a song or with a poem or whatever. I just kind of like let it drift. And that poem was definitely adrift. LV, I'll call people by their full well, names, whatever, their full handle sometimes. It's also out of respect. Plus, I like the ring of it. Like, Lord Vitae. It sounds cool. LV sounds like a beer. Like, LV is definitely the friendly thing. LV is like, you want to hang out with them and have a beer because they probably are the beer, and you want to hang out with them because they are the beer. You're better than OV. You're like three steps up from OV, which is pretty good. And then, yeah, if you're hanging out with Lord Vitae, you're probably doing some business. You're probably scheming, perhaps finding a way to take over the universe or save the universe from being taken over. Either way, noble pursuits, but not as fun as LV. LV Tay. That just sounds cool. I'm LV Tay. What's happening? That sounds like how Sam Jackson would say your name. LV Tay! How you doing, baby? Get this motherfucking LVT off my motherfucking street. Tonight's been a night full of songs I haven't played in a dog's age, and they've been really hard. So, I'm glad I haven't blown all of them. Now, I'm going to play this song. It's going to be my last song. Because this used to be my closing number. When I played Blue Skies Music Festival in 2005, this was my last song. And I had it in my pocket, as my last song. And thankfully, while I was out on stage, the MC Magoo, there were all sorts of technical problems with the band that was going to play after me. And he kept popping his head through the curtain going, you got one more in you, you got one more in you. So a three-song set turned into an eight-song set. And I was just waiting for this song to come out and be my closing song. And when I finally played it, I was exhausted. I had so much adrenaline running through me. Because I grew up at that festival, and it was family and friends, and you'd think that would make me feel comfortable, but actually I was incredibly nervous about it. It was a really big deal to me. And I played this song, and I feel like I nailed it, and it felt really good. We're down to three viewers, so I'm just singing for the three of you. Hopefully you enjoy this last tune. It's called Casablanca and Dionysus. Warm wine on a cold night, a blanket made for two, Casablanca's play on an old TV. Things that get us through in the old gods watching, giving us bounty for just this moment. So I'd like to linger with you.
move in just a little bit closer. Close enough so I can catch the scent of your hair as you turn your head. And if those guys are watching, I want Dionysus to see the sweet love that can happen between you.
That's Casablanca and Dionysus. Thank you so much, folks, for sticking it through. Patter, LV, Guy. You've been excellent. Thank you for all the requests. Lots of fun. All right. Thanks, everyone. Have a good one.